It was saying two.
Okay. What's this countdown?
I don't know, but that says 16 minutes.
Is this another countdown? Oh my god, is this gonna work?
Is that counting down?
Yes, 11.
No!
There, it's live.
There! We're live! We're live!
Well, that's because you hit start. Live in 9, 10. Oh, no, that's counting up.
Yes.
Okay, well, we'll see if it shuts off.
Welcome to the Ken and Barbie!
Shut! That was a bit, what?
I'm Ken.
I'm Ken.
And I'm Barbie. For the people who don't know us, honey.
Okay. Sure. Sure. Well.
Welcome.
So I hope everybody's doing well. I'm going to turn it off. Ready? Or do you want me to keep it going?
I'm not caring.
Let's keep it going. Keep it going.
It's almost done.
No way. It's only halfway. Well, no. You're right. It's almost done. We had so much fun with that.
Yes, we did.
That was so much
fun. Hi, Jody! Welcome. Thank you for coming.
How's it going?
I haven't talked to Jody in
too long. I said
it's
hi.
Time to talk to Jody. I need to talk to Jody more often.
Yes, I think you should. Absolutely.
Welcome, everybody. Come on in.
I hope things are going good for you, Jody.
All right.
We got, hey, Jody, we got the bill for Barbie's...
My bill for my infusions a couple weeks ago was $27.
$27.
Ooh.
Isn't that awesome?
It went from $750 to $27.
Oh no, it went from $1,500.
$1,500, yeah, for 2 days.
Because that's what you got. Well, but what, oh, Hugh's birthday is tomorrow.
Yes.
Wow, happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Hugh. Happy birthday to you.
And many more.
Yes, this is season 9.
Hi, Rhonda.
Season 9, episode 7.
One more.
A funny thing happened today.
One more episode after this.
Hi, Rhonda. A funny thing happened today, let me tell you. Well, a few funny things, actually.
Okay, tell me.
What is that? Just rogue hair. Wow. So, today...
It's a new color, rogue. It's a new color.
No, it's like... So the phone rings today, and I said, hello, and nobody said anything. So I said, hola, and then the person switched. They were like, hola, ¿cómo está? I said, muy bien, ¿y tú?
He started going off.
Yeah.
He started like in full sentences.
Full sentences in Spanish. I understood it.
His whole spiel, he's like, oh, thank God I got somebody that knows Spanish.
And I didn't know like what he was saying.
And then he said solar.
And then he said solar. And I was like, no me gusta. And then I said, okay, bye. Adios.
Yeah, he didn't last
very long.
But
he thought that I spoke Spanish because...
Because she said hola.
I said hola instead of hello. And so he thought I like full on
I was trying
Spanish.
To get her to say.
But I sounded
uno
really.
Cervezas, por
he
favor.
Said, hey.
Uno más cervezas, por favor. That's what I was trying to get her to say.
Yeah. But
one more beer, please.
Yes.
That's my Spanish.
Yeah.
Because
well,
I
mine
live
was
in
pretty good.
Arizona.
Was my Spanish pretty good?
It wasn't bad. It had that
it wasn't
guy.
Bad.
That guy was full fooled. On ready to
he
talk.
Was like, blah, 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 blah. I was like, bien? Good,
yeah.
Good. Bien
gotta
means
go.
Good.
And then it was done.
¿Cómo te llamas? What's your name?
You know, I've gone through a few of those Spanish courses with, oh gosh, what was the online course? Rosetta Stone.
Rosetta Stone.
They're very, very
took
helpful.
Me a long time to think of
they
that.
Are very helpful. And they're actually pretty easy to
yeah.
To do. Daniel,
yeah.
What's up?
Daniel, yeah. So I actually got to use some of my Spanish today, and the guy actually thought I spoke Spanish. So, wow.
Fooled the best of them.
Yeah.
Hey, Rhonda,
I just probably sounded like a white Spanish
Rhonda said
girl.
Her oldest got engaged this week.
Congratulations. Is that Dennis?
Right?
I think that's Dennis.
Yes. Well, that's a big congratulations.
Yes.
So is there a song for that?
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
No, that's not anniversary.
No.
Happy engagement. Happy engagement. Happy engagement. Happy engagement. Happy. Anniversary.
We get on our anniversary. Her brother sends us this Fred Flintstone song.
Hey, Rick.
They're awesome, both in there saying, happy anniversary, happy anniversary,
happy anniversary, happy anniversary.
That's where that came from.
Yes.
It's the Flintstones.
Okay, have you ever like heard a song?
Hi, Rick.
And you just think like you know the words, so you sing it that way for like years, and
And somebody comes along and does
somebody
a remix?
Comes along like somebody comes along like Ken and was like, where did you get those words from? Did you just make that up? And I was like, yes, I did, because I thought that was the song.
What song are we talking
about? We will rock you. And I said, buddy, you're an old man. What do you say? I'm going to get mad in your face one day. You got mud on your face. You're a big disgrace. Waving your banner all over the place. Singing, we will rock you. Rock you.
Well, I think you were close. You just weren't quite there.
But see, my sister, you know that song, Supercell Bar? You know that song?
I can't keep up. Sister, you're going way too fast for me.
And my sister, carry on. My sister says, Super Sack Funk.
Okay.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah.
Hey, Ross. Hey, Wyan. Wyan?
Hey, go back up.
Sanjaya's here. All right, go back up.
Oh, nice. Jonathan.
Jonathan.
Is Jonathan the one that got engaged?
Jonathan got engaged. Congratulations, Jonathan.
Well, very nice. Ross.
Jason.
How's your headache? Ross has had a neighbor clawing at his head all day.
That sucks.
Well, there's a little story to that.
Her son's names are Jason and Jonathan.
Dennis.
But Jonathan asked us to call him Dennis. So
right,
is Jonathan
right.
not Dennis?
Well, I think Dennis was a middle name.
Yeah, Dennis was his middle name, but he said, I go by Dennis. So we said, okay.
So it's the same person
we thought
they got engaged.
That's the name you want to be called by. I'm going to call you by whatever name you tell me you want to be called by.
Well, of course. Why wouldn't you? So it's Jonathan.
Jonathan and Jason.
And Jason. Right?
Yes.
Correct us if we're wrong.
Or Dennis.
Otherwise, we'll just keep saying it wrong and not know.
Week after week after week.
Hey, okay. Ross, I was wondering. So you left your cottage by the lake? And because it was getting too loud, or you're going to the cottage by the lake because it was getting too loud?
So the Father's Day is coming up, and
yes,
I don't have a father.
It's coming up
but
very
Ken
fast.
But Ken has one.
It's coming up really fast.
Ken has a father. So I am, my medication's working, the sun is shining. The pain is
right?
level two.
Ross had
I'm
it.
I'm doing great.
It's like
awesome day, and I'm loving life. So I'm showing my love. All right, let's
I'm
show
just
up.
Gonna sit back
okay, this
and
is
watch.
What we got. His Ken's dad is on Facebook, but he doesn't
do you
know
see
how
him?
To use Facebook
okay.
unless we're sitting there with him. So he
yeah, so
sense.
I don't mind.
So we can share with you what we got him for.
This is
Father's
what
day.
I got him for Father's Day. Now keep in mind. So he has a flip phone.
He has a flip phone.
And he can barely find, like, speaker on it.
He accidentally
so
hung up
like,
on Ken
on,
today.
So he's like, hold on, hold on. And
he accidentally
like,
hung up on Ken today so trying to switch it to Sue speaker.
I got him these.
We got him these.
Okay. We got him a pair of earbuds.
A headset.
It's earbuds. So he can plug it into his cell phone and then make the call and keep his phone in his shirt pocket and talk to people. So he doesn't have to do this all the time because he's not much for doing this. He likes to get off of the phone.
Yeah.
So
we can have longer talks.
This is a test to see if he'll stay on the phone longer.
Yes.
You think it'll work?
Well, we isolate.
It used to keep me on the phone longer because you didn't have elbow tinnitus. What elbowitis?
Yeah. Not tinnitus. That's in your ears.
I know. I corrected myself.
Okay.
I said elbowitis.
Tennis elbow.
Well, I don't play tennis.
But it's called tennis elbow. That is a technical term.
Okay, so this is one thing that we got. It was like $10. So
yeah.
that's
okay.
Easy, fast, simple. Okay, and then we got
go,
him.
Goose.
We got him one of these.
And then, yes. So this is something we talked about in past seasons.
Yeah,
of
you
the
may
show.
Remember.
So we got him I like it. It's a tiger tail.
It's
although, I like it better when I do it on myself. When Ken does it on me, it's a little hard.
Yeah.
Even though it's probably the same. It's probably the same pressure, but my brain registers it so differently. Like, how do I do
you can
it
really,
when you do mine?
You can really take out the cramps with
when
this.
When you do mine, when you rub my muscles, what do I do? Stop!
That's what it has. There you go. Oh my God.
I didn't know you were going to do that.
Well, it was a perfect display.
Thank you.
Yes, you're welcome.
Oh, that was light. But so that's the two things we got for his dad.
So that's going to be Father's Day. I hope all of you have a great Father's Day in advance.
And happy Father's Day, Ross.
And I hope, this comes with like a manual.
It comes with
a
whole manual of keeping your muscles happy.
All these like different things that you can do, how to use it, and what muscles to rub on to get this, or if that hurts, whatever, yada, yada, yada. So we know he likes it because we have one, and he saw it, and he used it, and he's like, wow, that's really nice.
Yep.
And so he's going to have a nice surprise when he gets one for himself.
Yeah.
I think, maybe.
Probably. So,
he'll have this.
Coming up this weekend is
Father's Day.
Father's Day and Paula's birthday weekend. I'm participating in Hugh's birthday.
Not this weekend, though. He's ahead of the weekend.
Yeah. Well, Billy's birthday's coming up, too. So I'm participating in a 5K rush to the finish line for Paula's birthday to raise money for the Fred Astaire Dance Foundation.
And?
They said don't announce the other one because the other one's a surprise.
Oh, okay. And then, so the other thing I was going to say, hey, if you're all in if you forgot something at Father's Day.
But I'm not running, I'm rolling.
And you're on the way over to Father's Day, you can always pick up a back scratcher.
I love my back scratcher, especially on fluconazole. This back scratcher scratches everywhere.
She likes this better than the roller.
Oh yeah, a lot better. So it's awesome.
Yeah.
Like I keep one at
we
my
keep one
bed.
At our office desk.
Yes.
We keep one
at the couch.
In the bed.
In the bed.
And the sofa.
In the sofa. So it's, the bed is to spank each other. Just kidding.
Oh, secrets.
Ow.
Secrets.
Ow.
Secrets.
It hurt me.
It hurt you.
I put my finger inside that string and pulled the wrong direction.
You going to be okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Very good. So, okay, well, that was fun.
Oh, and guess what else is this weekend?
Has a happy and great Father's Day. What else is this weekend?
My 30-year high school reunion.
30. You know what? She said this to me.
Wait a second.
You graduated in 1990? And she's like, yeah, it's my 30 year. I'm like, yep. Wait a second.
89 is my time. Yo, 90 is my year. Lay down.
Mine was like
in. Play that funky music till you die.
God, I can't get a word in.
Go ahead.
It's really where you're wearing me out, really.
Oh, boy.
Okay. So she goes, it's my 30-year reunion. And it's like, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, oh, my God. Mine was last year. I didn't even realize it.
Yeah.
It's like, you made me realize I forgot my reunion last year.
I'm sorry.
30 years.
Did your school do anything for your reunion?
No, that's why I didn't remember it. Nobody did anything.
Yeah.
I know, one of the guys started gathering a list and started, pulling people in and all that,
And
I thought something was going to happen, but nothing ever did happen.
Oh.
Or at least, maybe I just wasn't invited.
He might not have been invited, y'all. So Daniel's been clean and sober for 30 years on Sunday. That's a huge congratulations. Huge congratulations to you. That's pretty freaking
awesome.
Oh, wow.
That is a milestone. That's huge.
Yeah, and some of my friends were like, oh my gosh, the last like 30 years were like, it seems like yesterday. I'm like, really? Like, I feel like I've lived two lifetimes since then. Like, I lived my life up to college.
Well, things are cyclical. Things go in cycles,
yes.
Right? That's
so,
what
so,
I'm
so
saying.
I'm
mean, because
fourth
so
life.
You have this that happened in those, that decade or something.
Uh-huh.
And then you kind of like move in and mature more.
Or you get really, really sick and go into a wheelchair.
Well, that's a big one because.
And then you come out of it.
Right.
And
go through treatments or have more failures because for failed treatments.
Well, that was my my third life.
Third.
That was my third life. This is my fourth life.
I think I'm not quite like a cat. I'm not on my ninth.
I hope I get to nine. Like a cat.
Oh
my gosh. That would freaking be awesome.
I don't know. How about just one really good long life?
Sure.
What? Wouldn't that be more awesome?
Yes. So Rhonda's 42nd year anniversary.
Is this year?
Is this year, yeah.
Okay.
I remember going to my dad's and like school, high school reunion with him, and everyone was just like, oh, oh, Jim, 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 Jim. Jim's his name. Not that we were in the high school gym. But he actually had
I bet people guessed that.
Yeah.
Jim's his name.
Jim. I was like, oh, my dad's a Jim. But we actually had his 30th reunion in a bar. It was actually in a bar.
Well, I mean.
And my grandma was like, you can't go to the bar.
Yeah, but how many people were in his class?
Oh, like 10.
Yeah, so why wouldn't it be in a bar?
Yeah, it's like 10 people, and all 10 people made it.
They could all gather around the same pool table.
Right. We had like 423 people in our class.
I had.
Something like that.
Okay, I had 89.
89 is my time, and you graduated in 89.
You just figured that out of all these years.
Did they like cap it? You can't have. You can't have.
I think it was because somebody didn't graduate, or a few people.
Oh,
didn't
so it
should
have been 90.
Or 90 something.
Yeah.
Yeah, but hey.
Jody's 30th was 3 years ago.
Okay. Well, we're all in the same, like, era, right? We're all
Most
in the
of
same.
Us.
What about Ross? Ross, when did Ross tell
Ross
us
Ross, like,
earlier?
I'm telling you? Okay, so
13.
Sleeping positions.
I thought you said 30. Sleeping, well, okay,
go
ahead.
Let's talk
about
sleeping positions. So every day, every night, if I wake up, I look over, Ken's snoring and he's laying. He's usually on his back when he's snoring, and he doesn't sleep with a regular pillow. He sleeps with a neck
just
pillow.
Like, roll me over onto my side, and I'll stop snoring.
Yeah, we lost viewers.
Excuse
when
me.
I said sleeping positions.
I will stop breathing heavy is what I meant to say.
Oh, yeah.
Because I don't snore. I breathe heavy.
Yeah, so we have electronic beds.
That's my story.
Beds,
I'm sticking
so
to it.
I will, like, slap the bed. I will cough. I will kick my own bed. I will rub his back if it's towards me and I'm towards him.
I don't know that I've ever felt that.
It's happened.
It's usually like,
ooh. Holy crap.
I have never done that.
Don't even joke. That's horrible.
I was trying to be funny and I hurt myself.
Yeah, that's because that's a full-on lie. That's not even a seed of truth. This reality here, there's got to be a seed of truth in there somewhere.
No, that's what it sounds like because she, like, slaps the bed.
Yeah.
Well, it's better than slapping
me. I don't slap a human.
But I'll, like, wake up to her going with her feet. She'll be, like, with her feet. Or you'll be slapping the bed to, like, wake me up.
And I'm just trying to get you to roll over without waking you fully up.
I know, by slapping your bed.
Yeah.
And it does. It works. And, I mean, we have a foam bed, so it's not as though it bounces or I feel it. I hear it.
Yeah.
Which is fine.
Okay.
It's better than feeling.
I do not hate him. Okay, but Ken mentioned the other day that when he wakes up and sees me sleeping, what happens to me?
Oh, my God. It hurts me. Because, okay, so we have these adjustable bed frames, like, you know, by remote.
That's the word I was trying
and so
to say.
So she tilts her head up. The head of the bed up to, like, watch TV because we have it, like, mounted on the ceiling. And she'll, like, fall asleep that way. And I'll, like, look over in the middle of the night and she's, like, laying on her stomach sleeping. But the bed is still tilted up. So it's like, it's, like, painful to see. So I know that there's one button that we have on our remote that just...
But guess what?
And it flattens. So I try to find the button and flatten it out so that...
So I'm not all crinkled?
I feel like I'm helping her, but I think I'm actually doing it for myself.
So you feel better?
So I can I can rest easier.
Aww.
And knowing that she's sleeping better.
Yeah.
You like how I recovered that?
I do. So I just thought that was interesting that I sleep on my stomach, but at an angle with my head up. It's kind of funny.
It sounds painful. It looks painful.
I don't know.
Think it has to be painful.
Maybe I'm dreaming about doing gymnastics and, like, backflips or something.
That could
know.
Be, but okay, to hold the position. I mean,
the
you're,
bed's
you're like
holding
this.
The position.
Nobody's
for me. It
back.
Takes no muscle.
Nobody's back is like, you can't just sleep like that.
That's my hips. I'm stretching my hip flexors.
Okay, whatever you want to say, man. It still hurts me.
I don't know. Sounds fun.
I can't even sleep on my side if the bed is like tilted up.
Yeah.
Can't do it. But
either that or I'm in a ball.
That's usually like fetal position. Used to be a lot. I think since ketamine, you've been like kind of straightened out a little bit more.
Yeah. I slept in a ball. The worse the pain is, the more ball I get.
Everybody knows what you mean. I'm sure of it.
You know, like a roly poly.
Absolutely. Like, armadillo.
A roly poly, those little bugs that you play with as a kid. Uh-huh. And they roll up into a ball when you touch them because it hurts.
That's you.
That's me. I'm a roly poly when I'm in pain.
Or an armadillo.
Or an armadillo.
Or a possum.
Oh my gosh. I went to Texas. And.
Like on a plane?
The first time I ever flew on a plane. Oh, okay. Yeah, I was in college. And I went to Texas. And for a NACA event, and they told me on the plane, I was a vegetarian, and they told me on the plane that they everybody in Texas eats armadillo, and that it's like a requirement. You have to eat armadillo when
I don't think this is true. Go ahead.
This is true. This is what they told me.
No. Go ahead.
Okay. They told me, and I was literally crying on the plane. I was excited to be on my first plane trip, but then I'm like, why did I get on this plane? Like, somebody should have told me this before I got on the plane. I don't want to eat an armadillo. And and I was crying on the plane in college, mind you. I was crying.
I don't want to eat an armadillo.
And I was so upset. And they were just messing with me, but it was my first time, and I didn't know, like, oh, if you go there, you got to eat their food. Like in Thailand, you have to eat the Thai food. Like you don't get Oreos, you know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So when you go to Texas, you know, do you got to really eat the armadillos? Like, are they really going to serve me armadillos?
It's a lot of sandwiches.
I'm like, well, when I went to prom, I ordered a steak to look normal, like next to all the other people.
Oh, because you're a vegetarian. Because
I'm a vegetarian. And then I just cut the steak up and pushed it around my plate. And I'm sure it pissed off my dates because I went to like 8 proms. But... with 8 different people, but and I can't remember. I remember one guy's name was Eric. That's all I remember, and none of them were my boyfriend.
Moving off the point.
But I just pushed the steak around the plate, and hopefully none of them noticed that I probably pissed them off.
Absolutely, they noticed. They were just like, I want that steak, but I'm too nervous to look like a pig.
They should have just taken the steak because
I know. But then they would have felt like, oh my God, I'm not gonna be that guy that eats my date's dinner on prom.
You should be that guy. My sister and her boyfriend at the time, he stole a whole pie and walked out with it.
Oh my.
For free.
Nice.
At the prom, before the prom, at the dinner before the prom, he stole a pie.
Oh my, where were you? Cheesecake Factory?
No, we were at like a Manchie's fancy restaurant. I didn't pay, so I didn't pay attention. I don't know what it was called, but it was in DC.
Girls have it easy during prom.
If I could have ordered what I wanted, I would have gotten like a salad and been fine. I would have just got appetizer and bread, and I would have been like so happy, and it would have cost the boy like $5 or $6. But no, you have to sit down and order a real meal. And I'm like, all right, well, let's see how this goes. Like,
I don't have to pay for it. I can do that.
I don't have to pay for it. All right.
Give me.
I'll cut this steak up and push it around my plate.
What do I want to say? I just want to read the menu.
Order for me. As long as you don't order seafood. I'm allergic to seafood.
I'm
going to
practice. You probably practice saying filet mignon.
Filet mignon.
Before prom, I just need to know how to say it. I'm not going to eat it. I just need to know how to say it.
On top of that, my sister.
I'm sure of it.
My sister told me that you're never supposed to eat in front of a boy. So.
Oh.
Potential spam.
Potential spam. Never supposed to eat in front of a boy?
You're never supposed to eat in front of a boy. So. Even my boyfriends, I did not eat in front of anybody. I would make my boyfriend sit at the table behind me, and I would sit at this table and finish eating, and then I would come and sit next to him. I know, weird, but that was my sister taught me that you're not supposed to eat in front of a boy or he won't want to be with you, so I wouldn't eat in front of boys. Even my own boyfriends. I'm like, you want to go on a date to go take me to eat? Like, you're strange. Why don't we go to the movie theater where, like, the lights are out?
You can't see me eating popcorn.
Right? Like, oh no, I don't want any popcorn.
But that's kind of a thing in high school. There's so many different pressures coming at you to be liked and accepted and everything like that.
I rely on my sister.
Most of them are not true.
I know. Now I don't care.
Well, I noticed.
And I only eat what I want to eat. Well, I didn't eat what I didn't want to eat then. I just pushed it around.
Can I have some something crunchy? Just something crunchy. That's all I want. Just something crunchy.
Yeah.
Crunchy. I just want something crunchy. I want something that's louder than the television when I crunch on it. That's Barbie. The crunchier chips, not the. Those are too soft. I don't want flour tortillas. I want crunchy
corn
shell.
Tortillas, please.
Give me
you call this a taco?
If you can't hear me eating it, I don't want it. Cereal, I don't want milk with that. Then you can't hear me crunching on it. It's like, oh my God,
so
it's
funny.
Cereal time. How about an egg? Is it loud? Is it crunchy? Can you make it crunchy for me, please?
Backing up a little, Rhonda has a queen-size bed to herself.
Well, that's kind of nice.
I sleep in a twin-size bed. I feel like I'm on I Love Lucy.
Rhonda, do you have any pets, dogs, cats? Because if you do, I doubt the bed's for yourself. I forget, does Rhonda have any pets?
I think she has a dog.
I think so, right? Rhonda, what is your dog's name? What's on top of the roof? What's on top of the house?
Woof.
I said the punchline.
You did a Barbie.
Hey, you want to hear a cat joke?
Just kidding.
Okay, fine.
All right.
Rhonda, do you have a pet? We're delayed here. We're delayed. We have to be delayed here.
We are totally delayed.
We need to
know we have a pet.
Oh my goodness.
My throat's
okay.
So sticky.
Yeah, take a drink. I'll get the next line out. What are we watching? Okay, no pets for Rhonda. So you do have the bed to yourself. It's all yours. You and the pillow. I like to sleep. I'd like to have a pillow.
A what?
I like to have a pillow like between my knees. So, because
yeah.
I'm
he
a side
sleeper.
He puts
a head pillow between his knees and then he puts a neck pillow on his neck.
Yeah. I'm kind of weird.
And
I can't,
on his back.
You know, for the longest time, I would wake up with a headache. It's like I can't find a pillow that works without waking up with a headache. So I started using neck pillows that you would get at like the airport, and they would offer me the support that I needed. So, but I like sleeping on my side, so I like stack two of them. Wow. But I like to have a pillow between my knees when I sleep on my side.
Yep.
She used to be like, "Why do you have to have a pillow between us?"
I don't want to have anything between us.
She used to think it was to create separation between us.
Yeah, I'm like, why do we need a pillow?
No, I like to have a pillow between my knees. I'm facing you when I sleep.
I don't say pillow, whatever. I say Pella.
Pella. Like the windows. Pella. Like, no, I
no,
say
like
pillow.
The Pella on your
it's
bed.
It's a pillow.
It's a Pella.
It's a pillow.
Pella.
Pillow.
It's cabinet.
Put one in the comments for pillow.
And two in the comments for Pella. And for cabinet, put one.
Cabinet.
Or cabinet. Say it. You say
it. I say cabinet.
I say cabinet.
I said cabinet.
No, you do not say cabinet.
I just said cabinet.
You say like three syllables.
Cabinet.
That's what he says.
That's what
That's
you
number
hear.
One. Cabinet is number two.
Cabinet. Put it
and
in the cabinet.
And then third is a thing that colors when you're a kid. Number one.
Oh, crayon.
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 Crayon, number two.
Like cranberry?
Yep.
Like cranberry.
Crayon.
Cranberry.
Like a crayon you draw with.
Cranberry you eat.
You crayon you draw with.
Crayon.
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 It's a crayon.
Give
a
me a crayon.
In a cabinet.
I like colored crayons. What I like the red crayon. It's not crayon. I like the red crayon.
Yeah.
Red cranberry.
Pass
it's like you're not finishing a sentence.
Pass me the red crayon, please.
It's like you're not finishing a word.
Well, that's Ingle. I'm speaking Ingle.
Okay, fine.
Okay. So what have we been watching this week?
So we found a couple of new things, okay? Because we finished, the last thing that we finished was, well, I think we told you. But anyways, we found this other thing. It was really cool. It was called Hyperdrive.
Rhonda's husband sleeps in the other room because he has nightmares and he hits her.
Oh, no. Yeah, that's time to find
himself.
Another bed.
He hits himself. He hits it.
Yeah,
sleeps.
You don't need to be dealing with a night pounder. Is that what? A night pounder.
A night pounder. Oh my.
No, one, I can remember as a kid.
A night pounder.
If I woke, I can remember as a kid, I had a cousin come over and he was like quite a bit older. I thought he was cool. I'm like I'm really young. And I was like, hey, can we sleep? I want to sleep with him. You know, so I go in the middle of the night.
Whoa!
I woke up crying. Like, ah, got beat up in my sleep. That's a night pounder. And that's all I remember that to this day.
No, a night pounder is not.
It's a night pounder. A night puncher? A sleep puncher. You have a sleepwalker and a sleep pounder.
I sleep talker.
A sleep pounder?
Ken would say, oh, you told me that last night. And I'd be like,
your face woke my hand up.
That's what I should say when you snore.
What? Your face woke my hand up? Your face my face woke you.
Are we gonna get out what we watch this week?
Hyperdrive.
Hyperdrive was a show about racing.
He was hitting you. That's not good. That's not a sleep hitter. He's a sleep hitter.
That's horrid.
Some people are sleepwalkers and some people are just sleep hitters. Sorry, Rhonda, you got the sleep hitter. I am really sorry you got the sleep hitter.
I am a sleep talker. No?
You mumble.
I mumble?
You are a sleep mumbler.
I thought you said, oh, you told me that before.
Well, you don't talk in your sleep much anymore. I mean, nah.
Was that BK?
Yeah, but how often were you actually sleeping, you know?
Every time, because I don't remember it.
Well, like, REM sleep is, you know, whatever. So, the Waltons, oh my goodness, in color or black and white?
She said we that last week, and you said the same thing.
Right? Okay. I know, it's the same thing. So, when I think Waltons, it's like, well, I've seen a lot of the Waltons when I was growing up, and we got a TV.
At night, we watch alien shows while we sleep.
I love it.
It just absorbs osmosisly into our brains while we're sleeping.
Hey, did anybody see on Facebook? I posted my first video. I captured
a UFO. Where?
The first video in LA.
The City of Angels. That's where you should find them, right?
Well, yes. Go to my Facebook and you can see the UFO I filmed I captured a UFO.
We were trying to get the plane, but the UFO showed up.
It was after that plane. It chased the plane.
And Rhonda, I wasn't making fun of you getting hit in your sleep. I'm just making fun of Ken.
The sleep hitter.
Puncher, you said.
Well, she corrected me. He hits me in the sleep when he's sleeping.
Yeah.
So he's a sleep hitter. That's the correct term.
Yeah.
We discovered it. We put it together.
We discovered it.
We put it together. It's the sleep hitter. You saw it. Rhonda saw it. Okay. Yeah, I think Rhonda liked it. Okay. But wasn't that weird? It was like, I'm sure it was just an orb, whatever, like a piece of lint.
No, it was a UFO. I was there too.
It was unidentified.
It was unidentified flying
object.
That's
all I can say. It was unidentified.
And it flew at super speeds. Without sonic booms. That's a UFO.
It's
osmosis.
It's a UFO.
Yeah.
UF osmosis? Is that the O? Osmosis?
Is the O osmosis?
No. Okay. Object. Unidentified flying object.
Object. Okay. So, we're watching, this week we finished.
It was
Hyperdrive and Sleeper Cars. They're both boy shows.
Hyperdrive
is...
But did you like it?
I liked it.
Okay. American Ninja Warrior.
I wouldn't recommend it
for cars.
For a girl that's not into... what her husband watches.
But there was plenty of women drivers that participated,
or
and
boy
they
who's
did
not
really,
into.
Really well.
Yeah. Hyperdrive was pretty
but
awesome.
But so it's like American Ninja Warrior for cars. So it's a drifting contest slash different things. You know,
yeah.
They even had a swing where you had to like...
A teeter totter,
like,
but a
go
bridge.
Up here, take your car up here and get it to come down and then back up and balance this bridge.
for 10 seconds, and then you could drive off.
Yeah. Well, there was different levels, but yeah. There was, and you had to drift and knock out these objects that they planted, you know, part of the course.
Donuts
and slides, power slides, 360s, and it was awesome.
There was like six women drivers that did like so good. It was like the women drivers, I thought they were going to win the whole thing.
Yeah, but I mean, they did really well because they weren't as like balls to the wall. Like some of the guys were just got sloppy with their cars. I mean, they took the penalties because they tried to just go too fast. Like, I'm going to get the fastest time. Well, the ladies were beating them out because they weren't wrecking all over the place.
Yes. Rhonda said it was a UFO. I think it was a UFO too.
I'm saying it was a UFO. Yes.
And then sleeper cars, there was like seven rounds of sleeper cars, and they did three sleeper cars against a super sports car.
This was the other program we watched.
So what's a sleeper car? What's a sleeper car?
It's a garage. It's a car you build in your garage that doesn't look like it's got any kind of power. It might not have a real fancy paint job. It could be a Pinto or a
pickup
truck.
Have doors or sides.
Or a rust bucket. One guy had a minivan. But boy, was it fast. One guy had an electric car. The only car that wrecked was an electric car. But these sleeper cars would go up against...
The only car that was electric wrecked.
There were three sleeper cars that would go up against one supercar. Okay, and they did this how many times? Six times?
Six times. And then those six winners
competed...
For the final title.
At a dry lake bed in California.
Yeah, and the supercar, it was a yellow Lamborghini. It was
Huracan.
Like, it won.
What did it do?
And then it won. And all the other cars, they were literally left in the dust, including the other supercar.
He beat him by, they had to look in front of him to see where he was.
Yeah.
I mean, he just took off.
I mean, he literally.
And then it was a photo finish between a Ferrari and a
sleeper car.
A sleeper car, which was a Thunderbird that he built up, you know.
And the Ferrari had a woman driver.
And she was professional. I mean,
yeah, she
in
was
every
a professional
sense, she was
woman
like,
driver.
She's got tons of trophies, and they're billionaires. Her husband is a billionaire.
Right, her husband's
She's
a billionaire.
She's a billionaire.
Well,
they're
married.
Are,
they're both billionaires.
But a billionaire doesn't. It's like, hey, contribute yours so I can be a billionaire. It's probably, like, if you're going to create that kind of money, it's probably from one or the other.
All right.
I don't know. They never said. Anyways, it's not really the point. She was really good. But it was a photo finish between a Ferrari, and she lost.
A safari?
So, a Ferrari. And it was a supercar in first place, a sleeper in second, and then a supercar in third.
Yeah. But the supercar that won, the dude was a photographer. He was not a race car driver. And he just had to press a button.
Also.
And it went, pew, and
that
was done.
Out of the six winners, there were only
two supercars.
So that means all these others, supercars got beat.
Right.
Well, there was
of the things, I think it was like number four or five, episode four or five, there was
Which
four
was
cars,
it?
And then the supercar and another car like revved their engines and went past the starting line too soon and backed up, and they got disqualified for that. So that supercar would have won had it been a clean race.
And that was a McLaren.
That was a McLaren, yeah. But he
that was
didn't
a McLaren.
Get to win because
yeah.
he... Because
you were only allowed one burn off. He wasn't even trying to burn off. You had to be going like... miles an hour to get it into the race mode, and he couldn't get it into race mode, so he tried twice and it disqualified him.
Yeah.
So one got disqualified. The other one, she was like, she did really well, but she got freaked out because the car next to her spun out. The electric car wrecked,
and it scared her, and so then she slowed down.
And
then
that's all it took because it was that close of a race.
And then the other guy kicked on his nitrous and went,
if they had another 50 feet, she would have won. It was really close. Yeah. Anyways, that was fun. And then we started a new one.
Again, totally a boy show.
Yeah. Oh, this next one?
No. Hyperdrive and speed cars.
Those were definitely guys. Okay. So on Netflix, there was a new show that is, you know, the full season is there. It's called White Lines.
Yes. And White Lines
so far,
is
we're like
very
three
similar
episodes
to...
in. What do you think it's close to?
Well, first tell me what it's about, and then I'll remind
feel,
you.
I feel like White Lines is very close to, or similar to Bloodline, maybe. What was the were they?
No, it's the hotel one, the Florida one. They had a hotel. I think it was on like NBC, and they had a hotel in Florida. Anybody know what that one was? Last year it was on NBC. what's it called? Hotel. It's a family. Okay, tell what's about.
What, White Lines?
Yes.
Well, so far what we know is a girl discovered that her brother was murdered and buried on a rich person's property. Okay, the rich person
20 years ago.
20 years prior. So he's like mummified. Okay.
They thought he'd be eaten.
She thinks he was murdered. Now, the guy that owns the land thinks his son or his wife murdered. He's trying to investigate himself to find out who did it.
Yeah.
And so we're not too far into it, but it looks as though it was put together pretty well. And
it looks kind of like Bloodlines, a mix between Bloodlines and the hotel show from Florida.
Yeah, I can't remember what that hotel show from Florida is. Yeah, I don't know. So,
but I really like that hotel show from Florida too.
It's good. So I think we're going to follow it and watch it. So I think it's going to be good. And
yeah,
we're three, four, we're on episode four, I believe.
Yep. We just started that when we finished the other two. All right. And so if you want to support us, you can on patreon.com/KenAndBarbie.
Find
I'll
us.
Spell out Barbie with a Y. Why? Because you love me.
That's why. In a nutshell.
In a nutshell.
That's why.
Yeah. So we got some other
stuff. Oh, hey, we got a fire. We have a fire in
We do
Arizona,
have a bad...
Close to our
what's
house.
What's those kind of fires? Forest fires? It's not
forest
a forest
because
we're in the desert.
It's a... Well, but it's still a...
What's it? A mountain fire?
Well, I guess because it's
what's
over
it
the
called?
Mountain. It's a
untamed fire?
It's an unwanted fire. A wildfire.
It's a wildfire.
You said untamed.
Untamed.
This is how I figured it out. Wildfire. We have a wildfire.
I can't be tamed.
In Arizona. And we can actually see smoke from our house.
Yeah. The air quality is really bad.
So, yeah, there's that.
Yeah, don't go outside if you live in San Juan Valley.
Well, but here lately we've had warnings for...
Valley fever.
I'll let you
warnings.
Share that. Because...
Wind is picking up.
Because she loves Valley fever.
Can I just be done with Valley fever?
I thought you loved it.
I'm never going out again.
I thought you loved Valley fever.
You're wrong.
Well, then why do you still have it? Why don't you let go of it? Throw it away. Be rid of it.
I am.
Get
I'm
rid
taking
of Valley
the medicines.
Fever. Nobody wants Valley fever.
Nobody
yeah, Valley
wants
fever
Valley
is crazy. And then this
crazy.
Whole COVID thing, because of Valley fever, makes you really think, like, oh my word, what would that be like?
Right.
Because you know what Valley fever is like.
The, you know,
COVID
I can't imagine.
Must be horrible.
But they say that like 95% of humans are going to get COVID. They're just trying to slow the roll so that there's enough hospital beds for everybody who needs them. As we go, and not all at once.
Well, that's not going to be possible. I mean, if
wear your masks, people.
I mean, there's only
100,000
hospital beds in America.
When you go out,
America.
When you go out, wear your masks.
Yes.
Wash your hands always, anyway.
And wear a mask.
And if you're high risk, definitely wear masks and possibly gloves. And.
And just think safety. Think safety for other people, and if not
for
yourself, but for other people.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, things are getting real weird in this country. Things are getting real weird.
We got some
you
things
hear
coming
about
up,
Aunt
some
Jemima
events.
And Uncle Ben. I heard about Aunt Jemima.
Did not hear about Uncle
I
Ben.
I did not hear about Uncle Ben, but that doesn't surprise me.
But Aunt Jemima,
what about
syrup with
I'm sure
the butter,
everything
the
is
going to
get criticized, condemned, put down. I'm sure they're probably
so
going to get like, we can no longer do Mr. Goodbar or something. It's just that getting that crazy. That was a good one.
Yeah, it was a good one.
But yeah, it's just absolutely, and if anybody knew the story behind the Aunt Jemima, like pancake mix and
syrup
and stuff.
It wouldn't even
have
taken away.
The lady got very, very wealthy and was able to do great, great things
for the
because
black community.
Of Procter Gamble that gave her all, you know, that made her, and it was a lifelong contract, I heard. You know, so she did wonderful work. I don't know if she's still alive or not.
But if she's not, she probably passed those rights on to her kids or grandkids.
Right, but so
and,
now what?
And so now what? Now they're gonna. Now their family's not gonna make the money that they were gonna make. That's so sad.
Well, and then yeah, so.
And it was so tasty. It was tasty.
Well, Ronna, you have to be careful if you're if you're diabetic, you're high risk.
Oh my gosh.
It is definitely true. You have to be careful.
Yeah. I don't even like leaving the house. So.
Well, and a lot of times we don't need to. So that's what's been.
Next week's
nice.
Our last show for this season.
Next week is yes. Yep. Next week, it'll be sayonara for another year.
Hope not a whole year. Right? We'll pop back in to
well, it's easy to stay up with us and follow us, and we're on a lot of different social medias, so. We're always active with the foundation, and
yes, we had some things coming up with the foundation. So in Friday, July 17th, we're doing a webinar on self-care isn't selfish with Dr. Heather Gilmore.
You said July 17th?
July 17th, so, one month. And that 1 month from today. And then August 20th, we're doing a webinar with Mia Masak, who has migraines, and she just published a book, and she's going to do a webinar on migraines and mindfulness in August. And then we have the I Give a Care, I Run, I Rock, I Roll for Eye Pain on September 19th. And that registration opened up this past week. And we're gonna miss you too. We'll still be around. We'll be on social, all the socials.
Yeah, we'll certainly be in touch with you. We won't let it go a year without saying hi or pulling you into something.
Yeah, they want to change their images so they don't have to pay the lady anymore.
It's just so kidding. Sad. It's sad. Really, really sad. And it's like, you know, what are we coming to?
That was like a job for that family.
It was a lifestyle.
Yeah.
I mean, she was able to do so many, and from what and I heard, she did a lot of great things.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So, and then,
there's a lot of,
lastly,
the summit.
Yeah. The Eye Pain Summit, the International Pain Summit 2020 is on November 14th.
And
Saturday.
That is getting put together. And
yes.
It's up and moving.
It's up and moving. And we have like 900 people that have already been like paying attention and listening to it.
So
or looking at what we're putting in.
We've got our speakers. Getting our speakers confirmed.
Yeah.
We've got our speakers lined down.
We haven't announced them all yet.
So it won't be long. We'll be putting that'll be all put together.
But we already have people registering. So that's awesome.
I know. It is really awesome. We're excited about that.
Yep. And
for sure.
Yeah.
Hey, so Rhonda,
and it's virtual, so you can participate from anywhere in the world. Patients, caregivers, and public have one price. The medical students have a price, and then medical providers and professionals have a price.
Very good.
Yeah.
So I was going to say, Rhonda, you said your son got engaged, right?
Yes.
Do they have a wedding date?
Are they going to have a big wedding, a little wedding?
A virtual wedding?
Virtual wedding?
Ours was virtual before virtual was cool.
We were ahead of the time.
We were way ahead of time.
Way ahead of the times.
We did it in Vegas, and so it was a small chapel. There was some people there, but it was
we
also being recorded.
We had 19 people at our wedding.
We gave some people the link. Her dad had a link and decided to call me to see if I would actually... I think they wanted to see if this was live or if it was delayed or something. So they decided
we were
live. To call me, and I'm like... Hello?
Ken answered from the altar.
They're like, you're not supposed to answer the phone, but you called me.
I'm about to marry your daughter. I'm supposed to answer the phone when you call.
Yeah.
So funny.
It was kind of funny.
Yeah.
That was a virtual wedding. So, and it went well. It's much, 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 you much
can,
cheaper.
You can call you and adopt me.
You can call, you can adopt me.
Oh.
Because, yeah, well... it gets really, really, it gets cold in the winter. Come and visit. Visit. Arizona.
Oh, they have not planned the wedding yet.
Oh, okay.
She gave her mom's ring. Wow.
Ooh, handed down through through
families.
Yeah, heritage or not heritage. What's it called? That's special.
Well, that's like crossing not just crossing a generation, but that's like onto the. You must really have a lot of faith in this girl because, I don't know.
Right. Well
when
I mean,
me and my ex-husband got
you don't want
divorced,
somebody to get pissed off and like keep the ring
back.
Or something, right? Yeah. So that's. Yeah, the tradition has to stay alive, and they have to pass it down and pass it down and pass it.
Can't get divorced if they got your mom's ring.
Right, it's another whole commitment, but that completes the whole ring, the whole circle. You know, so that's really awesome that was able to happen. So,
I had my wedding band from my grandma. My grandma and grandpa.
My mom's ring.
My grandpa passed away, and my grandma gave me her wedding ring, her wedding band.
Well, that's nice.
Mm-hmm. I still have it.
I don't have anything. Jewelry. Like,
I gave
stuff.
You a ring. What do you mean I got nothing?
Handed down, passed down to me. You're like,
who is this man?
I got nothing, man.
Where's the Sharpie?
Where's the Sharpie? The Sharpie.
Oh, I lost it.
Well, I guess I don't get a ring painted on me this week.
Nope. So I hope you guys have a super awesome and hot week.
Oh, it's definitely hot
for
us.
We got a lot going on.
It's coming up. It's been in the hundreds all week and week so far, and I don't think it's going to drop. I think right now it says 100.
Yeah, and the fires are making it probably even hotter, and the air's so dirty. It's such a dirty air quality right now. So it's like hard to go outside.
Yeah, it definitely melted the ice. The fires did.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, well.
She has two kids. Aww.
Oh, well, that's nice. Do you like the kids? Are they really sweet?
You can't say that live on air.
Okay, are the kids really, really sweet?
Of course they are. She could watch this.
Well,
high school
son and a middle school daughter.
High school son.
I don't know if anybody would have liked me at that point in my life. I was like, no, get your kid out of my house. Right? Because that'd be like in your refrigerator. Like, hey, excuse me.
For real? The only time I went in someone else's refrigerator was when they invited me in, except for when I babysat, I would steal pieces of bread. I'd steal like two or three pieces of bread and with some butter.
No, we ate like horses, my brother and I. But we were in like wrestling and football, and it was like we're always just pushing so much energy. We had to just eat. Yeah. We had to.
I was cheering. When I had to cheer, if we had a game, I would have a soda with sugars, like three sugars in it before each game. So I could make it to the end of the game.
Oh, weigh in. Rhonda said weigh in. That's right.
That's right there, and I forgot it, but I didn't. I still got it.
Oh, my.
Okay. All right. Let's go. Weigh in. Mine is 137. I did not lose or gain this week.
That's why we didn't remember the weigh in.
What is yours, Uncle Ken?
I am at 204. And good after
job,
we're done
baby.
With this, I'm gonna fix
pounds,
dinner.
2 pounds. Whoop. 2 pounds.
I got 1 week left to get down to 190.
I'm not going to make my goal, but that's okay.
My goal was 190. It's not happening.
Yeah.
But I might get to 200. I don't know. It's 4 pounds in 1 week.
Yeah. I don't know.
I could do it if I really, really, really push myself.
I'll have to get Ross and Megan and Tim's later. But I know Megan's doing quite well. Last time I talked to her, she said she was down to 163. And she started at 170, so that's 7 pounds. That's freaking phenomenal.
That's really good. Ross told me he was like he's lost like 15
pounds. Oh, did he tell you? Today?
I don't know. Ross isn't with it. Are you still here, Ross?
He lost signal.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. So yeah, he said he was down like 15 pounds.
193.
Great job, Rhonda. Great job.
Great job, not gaining, Rhonda. That's good.
Hi, Jonathan.
Great job. I didn't gain. Hello, Jonathan.
So, Rhonda said she hasn't met the kids. Well, because you're at a distance,
yes,
aren't
Jonathan's
you?
Yes, Jonathan's her son.
Yeah, at a distance.
Yep. So, and then, Tim and Ross and Megan will have to get theirs.
Jonathan's birthday.
Wait, didn't we already sing happy birthday?
But now he's not here.
It's not his birthday.
It's...
I thought it was his birthday, but it wasn't his birthday. Or something.
But early up, who'd we sing birthday? We sang
Hugh.
Happy birthday to Hugh.
It's Hugh's birthday.
Dum, 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 dum.
Happy birthday, Hugh!
Yeah, right? Happy birthday, Hugh. What was it? I don't know.
All right. Well, guess what time it is for us?
Dinner time.
That's right.
What are you having?
I am having...
I'm going to make a pizza and eat it in front
are?
Of you.
Oh, I'm having chicken and yogurt.
She can't do red sauce.
I cannot do red
she
sauce.
She can't do tomato.
No tomato.
Or at least, yeah. Well, it beats kidney stones.
Yes.
So
I like it, but
I bought a pizza. I bought a pizza and it said four cheese pizza. I didn't think it had red sauce on it. And I get home and she's reading the ingredients and it said it does.
Tomato paste. Ken,
yeah, I
my
knew.
Son.
I knew that was your son.
But is it the
Jonathan.
Son? Jonathan, did you get just get engaged?
That's yes. That's what it was. I oh my word.
We sang happy anniversary engagement.
That's what we sang. I was trying to, we sang something for
okay,
Jonathan.
We totally did.
That's why I was messed up and I couldn't mm-hmm. remember. Yes. Well, there is no happy engagement song, but there's happy anniversary song.
Yeah.
And Barbie sang it and put the tune to happy engagement. It didn't really sound that great.
Yeah.
But it was a thought that counts, Jonathan. You're in our thoughts and happy congratulations. For getting engaged.
Yes.
Hope it all works out for the best and you're happy for the rest of your life. And
the rest of hers.
And the rest of hers.
Hopefully awesome. You die at 100 together. That's my goal.
On the same day.
At the same time.
Oh my God.
In the same car accident.
What?
At 100.
No, it's got to be from like natural
causes. I want to be like instant. Take me instant.
Well, nobody wants to suffer.
Okay.
I mean, I understand that. Okay, this is like a bad topic.
Wait, right? We got 3 minutes left and we're talking about this. But it right. reminded me of like, I have my whole will done. I have my pictures picked out.
Barbie wants to go and be cremated.
Yes.
And then she wants her ashes to go...
In balloons.
In balloons for a cruise, on a cruise
helium.
Boat.
With
and
helium.
We take the balloons and release them to the sky... For
at
her
sea.
To
ashes to
float
ashes,
around the world,
dust to dust.
Where would she
you
land?
Got to be
what if it didn't pop? The helium. You know how helium doesn't like keep the balloon like tight anymore, and it just lands in somebody's like front yard, and they open it up and they pop it, and it goes. You'd be like, I'm moving in.
What if you got reborn like that?
Oh my God. it's like, oh, what lucky area did you fall
I was
in?
Hoping you were going to say...
Whose backyard did you...
I was hoping you were going to say it hit the like top of the atmosphere and got to go out into outer space.
I don't know that a little balloon would do that. Maybe.
We don't know. Where do all the balloons go?
If
don't
balloon...
write me balloons blows, I know.
Yeah, we used to like release air balloons in
I'm
the sky
going up in a balloon
as
anyway.
Awareness campaign. And we got beat up on by the balloons blow people.
Yeah.
The people that operate balloons blow.
Yep. But if I'm going out, I'm going out in balloons and helium. It's a party in here. Let my ashes be the confetti of the world.
That should be on a postcard.
Really? Can it be online?
May my ashes be the confetti to the world.
Yes. Can you remember that for when I pass away?
So, okay, yeah, I'll put that in your eulogy. Barbie said she would like to have her ashes be the confetti to the world. So we're going to put Barbie's ashes when she passes
he's gonna
in
go
a
on
balloon,
a cruise.
Hot, in balloons filled with helium.
Yeah.
And everybody there on the cruise is going to, which will probably just be me, everybody else, she's going to die last in her family.
I'm going to die first. What are you talking about? I mean, I'm not first. My mom, all my grandparents, my mom, my dad. So I'm next. And I'm not dying to 100. That means my father needs to live to 104.
Oh, my. Okay, well. We'll see how this goes.
Yeah. That's okay. My goal. That's my goal. But hopefully, everybody who loves me gets to go on the cruise. Start saving up now. And you got 60 more years.
We'll do a little fundraiser.
And
blast her off into the sky. So
yes.
Okay, well, thank you, Rhonda.
My pain pops.
Jonathan, congratulations again. It's
but I do not
exciting.
Want people to pop it's my balloons. I want the atmosphere too. And you can use latex balloons because they are...
She's not done yet, is she?
Latex balloons are biodegradable. So, because they come from trees.
They're made from the earth.
Did you know that? They are made from the earth.
They're all natural.
So put me up in an all-natural balloon and let me be the confetti of the world.
To the world.
To the world. The confetti to the world.
Very good.
Okay. Love you guys. Peace, blessings,
okay.
Hope, love, light.
Thanks for being with us.
Yes.
Hope
Have
a great
true.
Week.
And smile.